This is a Standing Eight Count special report.
It's amazing to me because when this whole thing started, I just had started boxing. I had maybe one amateur fight under my belt, and I remember laying in bed with my wife and kids and watching Peter Manfredo Jr. actually fight, and he was my favorite guy on the show. So the full circle that it's taken is just—it's amazing. It's awesome.
I can only imagine. I can only imagine. Talk about the cruiserweight division in general and how, of course, it has been neglected for quite some time. And there are people out there who may not even know it exists, which is sad. And now you get a part of this particular program to help, obviously, put it out there in the public. What does that mean to you?
Well, you know, ever since I turned professional, everybody that asked me what weight class I'm in, you know, when I say cruiserweight, everybody has been, what is a cruiserweight? What's a cruiserweight? You know, and it's a very unrecognized weight class. So this show has really put it right on the front line for everybody to see what a cruiserweight's all about, because it's a great weight class. You know, there's guys, the big guys that can punch, and they can also move, you know, so it was great.
As a New England guy, this must be awesome. Certainly, Peter didn't have, you know, this opportunity, having gone, of course, to Las Vegas and then the rematch being in Los Angeles. Guys like you get to see this show come back here to where you're from, as opposed to, you know, the first few that were out, of course, on the West Coast. What is that like, knowing that the contender has come to, you know, our backyard?
This is great opportunity. Let me tell you, when I found out that they were doing the finale here in the home court, It was amazing. You know, I was like, oh, I can't wait to be on that show. I can't wait. Because, you know, I got so much positive feedback from the show. And once they found out that they could follow me on the Contender Series and then at the end of the show get to come see me fight live, man, I was excited. Everybody's excited. So I'm going to put on a great show. I'm going to fill this place. Sold over 200 seats. So, yeah. So it's going to be great. Yeah. And that's from New Hampshire. Those guys are driving 3 hours, you know, let alone all the people that, you know, from the local area that are coming to see me fight. So I'm going to put on a great show.
I hope so, man. Absolutely. Talk a little bit about this guy over here. I barely know him. I don't know. Excuse me. Your name is George? What's your name again? How did this come about with this character over here?
Well, Manfredo Sr., he's the best trainer that I've ever seen or met. And he runs the show here in New England. You know, it's just the bottom line. I had met him in the amateurs because I fought one of his kids a few times, and you know, I couldn't wait to get in his gym. You know, and just recently, about 5 months ago, you know, I decided to make a location, you know, to relocate down here, down south in Massachusetts, you know, to further my career, because there isn't a whole lot of opportunity up north. And the first person I was thinking of was Manfredo Sr., because, you know, his training camp is like, it's like a boot camp on a regular day. You know, that's 6 days a week. We got great guys in there. We got Edwin Rodriguez, who's an amazing professional fighter. We got Jesse Brinkley. We got Peter Manfredo Jr. The list goes on. We got, you know, we got great amateurs, Toka, George. I mean, it's great. So, I mean, if any gym that I was going to go to New England, he was the first one. Period.
And I've been in there a few times. He even yells at me. So.
Oh, it's
so
amazing.
It's boot camp for me. And I'm
the pictures, the whole environment, just walking in there, just gives me chills when I first walked in there. I was like, I don't know if I'm ready for this. You know, and by the looks of my body and all the feedback I'm getting back from everybody, when I rip off my shirt, man, I'm in shape. I came to fight, man. I've never been so ready for a fight in my life.
That's good to know. My last question would be, as a guy who likes to bring it, and everybody, of course, who watches boxing, especially those who don't necessarily know that much about it, want to see guys like yourself, guys who are going to bring it. Just kind of talk about the strategy, certainly, for tomorrow.
You know, my strategy is pressure. You know, I've been working with nothing but left-handed fighters for the past 3 months. You know, when I found out that's my opponent was going to be Ryan Coyne, that's all I've been doing is working with lefties. You know, they have a tendency to make you look a little ugly. You know, it's kind of an awkward style. But at this point, I'm so comfortable with left-handed fighters, and you know, I'm going to do what I always do, and I'm going to bring some pressure. You know, and like I said on the Contender Series, I'm what boxing needs. You know, nobody wants to see somebody dance around, look pretty. I'm going to bring some pressure, and I'm going to make it a fight, you know? It's not a boxing match, it's going to be a fight. That's what people want to see.
This was a Standing Eight Count special report.